Angelo, and I want to share three facts about myself. Actually, it's three things I love. I love bacon. I apologize in advance if you're a vegetarian. I love Ultimate Frisbee. And I love Jesus, but obviously not in that order, okay? I think I'm in the right place. Now I can leave, right? No. So many times in life, we get an invitation. When I was in high school, I got an invitation from my friend Sue to go to, you guys ready for this? McDonald's. That's right. And this invitation involved skipping the last class of the day to go for the delicious, the sweet, the salty, the vegetable oil McDonald's French fries. Thank you. So I kind of want to explain my story and really what happened. Now, we had to go back to school that day because we had softball practice. So she kind of nudged me in math class and she's like, hey, let's skip the last class and we can go get the French fries. And I'm like, oh, that sounds like a fantastic idea. So there we go, we skip the last class, we're headed to McDonald's, we get and we consume the French fries, that goodness, it was amazing. And when things started to get dicey is when we were on our way back to school for practice. So I want to kind of maybe act it out a little bit, what took place. You see, I was driving, and my friend Sue was the passenger in the car. And I had my license for a short time, but I had my license, and my friend Sue had her license. But what happened was, on our way back to school, we hit a red light, so I stopped at the red light, like any licensed driver would do. And as I was stopped at the red light, a police car came next to me. Now, it's not a super big deal, but like, so I would be in my car right here, and then the police car right here at the red light. And I have my license, sure, maybe it's a little bit illegal to ditch school, but you know, whatever, like it was senior year, that's okay. But what happened was that police car, and inside that police car was my dad, the police officer. Yeah, but it gets kind of worse, so just. So I'm sitting here, my friend Sue is here, the police car, and my dad in the police car. And I was like, oh crap. And then like at that moment, my friend Sue, because she was such a genius, she's like, Kelly, it's okay, he didn't see us. And I'm like, Sue, I'm driving his car, like he's gonna know. So like at that moment, we kind of really like crunched down into our seats. And I'm like, dear Lord, please let the light turn green. Please let the light turn green. That was my authentic prayer, praying that the light would turn green. And like we would like look over at my dad in the police car and he would be looking straight and be like, yes, yes, yes. And we'd look back over and he'd still be looking straight and I'm like, oh my gosh, this is gonna work, this is awesome, okay? And we're like scrunched down. And then it was that next time we looked over, my dad was staring right back at us. And the anxiety I felt knowing that my dad knew we ditched school and just being a new driver with my license, the anxiety, the panic, the fear, I accidentally put my foot on the gas and I ran the red light. Yeah, I did pee a little bit, okay? It was pretty bad, but then once I ran that red light, I made a quick right, and my friend Sue, the genius again, she goes, Kelly, I think we lost him. And I'm like, this is so bad, and I had these visions that in my hometown newspaper, that would be like, daughter followed by father, police chase. But sure enough, about two blocks later, my dad, right behind us. Oh yeah, And I'm headed back to school, and I'm not sure what to do. I'm worried the sirens are gonna go off. He's gonna pull me over. He's gonna give me a ticket. I'm gonna lose my license, all sorts of things. And I'm like, this is really, really bad. And we're getting closer and closer to school. Sirens did not go off. I didn't get pulled over. I still have my freedom right now. And then I made a left in school, and my dad kept going. Hashtag merciful father, right? I was like sweating that one out. So you're probably wondering, why is she telling this story about McDonald's? And how does that connect to the Steubenville Youth Conference? So why am I telling you this story? I want to share about the invitation. And I first got that invitation from my friend Sue to go to McDonald's. And our talk tonight is the invitation. And it's an invitation to come and you will see. Now you might wonder, like, what do I want you to see? I want you to see that Jesus is real, Jesus is legit. A relationship with him is not only possible, but it's what he desires. The Catechism says, the Word became flesh so that thus we might know God's love. So in his infinite awesomeness, amazingness, wonderfulness, the miracles that Jesus did 2,000 years ago, he's still doing today, and he wants to bring them to you tonight. Whoa, that should be blowing all of our minds. So back to my story. When I was at that red light, I was experiencing a lot of crazy feelings, like fear, panic, kind of like Kevin at Home Alone, right? Like major panic. I was worried I am going down. Like this is gonna be over, no more freedom. I was in disbelief, and all I kept thinking, how can I hide? How can I hide? Guys, my father, the cop, caught me like red-handed. And I realized I had these same struggles and feelings in my own spiritual journey. And maybe some of you can relate to how sometimes life just gets messy. Life just gets chaotic. Maybe you fail a test. Maybe you break up with a boyfriend or girlfriend. Maybe you have a little too much to drink. You get drunk. Maybe someone makes fun of you, or you make fun of someone. I can tell you that I am exhibit A of all of these things, and I've experienced all of these things firsthand. And in each situation, I felt panic. I felt scared. I felt disbelief. I wasn't sure what I was gonna do or how I was gonna survive. And how do you survive? How do you get through something? How did I get through all of that? I can tell you, there's only one answer, and that's the cross. The cross is the answer. Because just like when I drove away from my dad, like, he was there when I got home from practice that night. And in my messiness, in my disobedience, he still loved me. He still cared about me. He still valued me, his daughter. So sometimes we run. Sometimes we sprint. We turn our backs. We avoid our Father in heaven. But he is always there, inviting us and welcoming us to him. When I was in high school, and this is kind of lame, you're probably gonna think this is a bit lame, but I used to play hide and go seek. Now let me kind of set up this story for you. We would play these amazing, epic games of hide and go seek, a group of friends and myself. And it'd be Friday night, we'd all go to the woods, we'd wear camouflage, we'd paint our face black, we'd like put leaves on ourselves. I mean, we would go all out, hardcore, crazy for these hide and go seek games. And on this one particular night, I remember instead of breaking into teams, we said every man was gonna be for himself. So if you were hiding, you were on your own, you weren't with the team. And I remember going to hide that night, and I hid behind a tree. Classic, right? And as I'm hiding behind the tree, maybe 2 minutes, 3 minutes pass, and no one came. And I was standing there, and I started to have those same feelings, fear, panic, and I started thinking, what if no one is gonna come? And my friends, it's not like I had this stellar hiding spot, because it wasn't, it was behind a tree. But I started having these fears. And then when I went home that night, and as I was trying to fall asleep, the same questions I was wrestling with. What if I'm all alone? What if no one comes? What if no one cares about me? What is the purpose of life? Why am I here? What am I doing? So I want to ask you guys a question tonight. And when I ask you guys this question, it might seem really simple, but I really want you to ponder it. What are you looking for? What are you looking for? Is it to have a lot of friends, to make a lot of money, to keep your Snapchat streak alive, to have 1,000 followers on Instagram? Is it to belong, to be accepted, to be loved? Because you see, the disciples asked Christ the same question. What are you looking for? In the Gospel of John, it says, the next day, John was there again with two of his disciples. As he watched Jesus walk by, he said, behold, the Lamb of God. The two disciples heard what he said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, what are you looking for? They said to him, Rabbi, where are you staying? He said to them, come and you will see. So they went and saw where he was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 p.m. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who had heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, we had found the Messiah. So Christ asked this same thing to his disciples. What are you looking for? And the response was from the disciples, we have found the Messiah. We have found the Anointed One. So when you think about what are you looking for, I want to offer something. Perhaps what you're looking for has been here the whole time. Perhaps what you're looking for is Jesus Christ. Because you see, it was when I was sitting exactly where you guys are now at a Steubenville Youth Conference that Jesus said, come and follow me. And that changed everything. That's when he became real, and that's when a relationship with Jesus elevated my life. It changed me. He said, come and you will see. So to everything that I was searching for, all of the questions I had, everything, all of my desires, it was Jesus. And he invites you to come and see. So as I started to walk with Jesus in high school, I was confronted with the truth that I was created in God's image. That in my messiness, in my brokenness, in making poor decisions like cutting school to go to McDonald's for French fries, and not being a morning person, not being able to cook, all these different things that Jesus created me, Jesus desired me, And Jesus loved me, and he would always love me. It didn't just mean he liked me, but he loved me, like me personally. And it's when I was sitting right where you are that he spoke to me. Not out of a far distant cloud, but in the depth of my heart, he spoke to me. And he said, Kelly, this is just the beginning. Kelly, we are just getting started. Because my friends, we have a God of new beginnings, and we have a God who makes things new. I've seen healing and reconciliation in my family and my friends. I believe Jesus Christ rose from the dead, and I'm seeing seeds in my life of the resurrection. Jesus isn't some superhero who's flying far away, but he's here present, and he's incarnate, and he wants to make himself known to you. Are we looking for him? Will we follow him? He gave us himself on the cross. You see, this cross, it's not just something cool we have in the room for decoration or decor. Maybe some of you have it in your bedrooms. Maybe some of you wear the cross around your neck. This cross gives meaning and purpose to our lives. This cross is hope and redemption. Recently, I was rafting and a speedboat was pulling me. And the lake that I was rafting on, they have these gators in the lake. I know you're probably thinking, wow, that was really stupid. You'd go to a lake with gators. But my friends encouraged me to do it because they thought it'd be a thrilling experience. And as I was on the raft, I was holding on for my dear life because I didn't want to fall into the gator lake. Because I thought I'd get eaten alive. And as I'm holding on, like, super, super tight. Actually, I'm going to have you play that clip. Why don't we? Ridiculously fast, okay? And I'm holding on for my dear life because I don't want to fall into the gator lake. And I'm holding on and holding on, holding really tight. One of my friends who's on the boat next, like right next to me, fell off. And I was like, I'm not falling off, I'm not falling off. And I'm holding on, I'm holding on. In that same way that I was clenching those handles of the boat, it's the same way that I hold on to the cross. And that's the same way we are all called to hold on to the cross. Because the cross is hope. In my work, in my ministry, I meet a lot of young people who don't have hope. A lot of young people who don't want another day. Maybe it's some of you in this room. A lot of people who come from abusive homes, from alcoholic families. Maybe some of you have suicidal thoughts. I don't know your story, but I know you have a story. And I know God desires to break through to you in a new and powerful way this weekend. Because like many of you, you've been here. You've been to Steubenville. You know what it's about. You've experienced the youth conference. But God wants to do something new in your hearts. And if you've never been, you don't have to listen to the stories. You can experience it and experience the encounter. Pope Francis said something really, really awesome. Pope Francis said, the Lord does not disappoint those who take the risk. Whenever we take a step towards Jesus, we come to realize that he is already there, waiting for us with open arms. Now is the time to say to Jesus, Lord, I have let myself be deceived in a thousand ways. I've shunned your love. Yet, here I am once more to renew my covenant with you. I need you. Save me once again, Lord. Take me once more into your redeeming embrace. My friends, our faith journey is not a one and done moment. It is a process. It is a walk with the Lord. Tonight, we have the best invitation. And it's from Jesus inviting you into his heart. In just a few moments, we're going to have an opportunity for Eucharistic adoration. And as Catholics, that's when we believe that Christ is truly present. And he's going to walk through these doors. And he's going to be looking for you. He's going to be seeking you. And he's going to be inviting you. He is the invitation. Let's pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, we give you ourselves, broken, hurting, seeking. We come as we are. Lord, I ask any distractions, any blocks, that you would remove them so we could experience you. So we could experience your loving embrace. So we could experience the encounter with mercy. Lord, I pray you open my heart. Lord, give me the grace to surrender. Give me the grace to be at peace with your will. Jesus, I trust in you.